Hey everybody, Brian and Cora here for some martial arts. We're going to go over our yellow and orange belt, or our beginner youth and teen striking requirements today. So we're really working on jab patterns, things like hitting head, body, head, or high, low, high, or hitting low, high, low, body, head, body, different patterns with the single, the double, and the triple jab. Okay, so I'm going to work with Ms. Cora here. We're going to just do the single, double, triple, all to the head or face area, and then we'll start doing different patterns after that. Also, before I get going, today we're going to do all of our patterns here. And then she hits me in the body, right? She comes back, hits me in the head, for example. That's how I'm going to hold. Sometimes we'll hold like this. High, low, right, and then however, right? So sometimes we'll even hold this way. Give me three, right in the middle. One, two, three, right? And I like sometimes to do like a red light, green light drill, especially on this beginner one where we kind of mix it up, okay? Sometimes also with our higher ranks, our more advanced students, they will do things like slip and hit. So they will always be going here. When you start catching and slipping, they'll always be going to this. So sometimes when we do with the beginners, we'll have them hit here too, all right? So Cora, just give me a single. Good. We want to move around just a little bit, and a double. Alright, we'll swap sides here, and a triple. Now, Cora's done jabs for a long time getting your base, so she's really good at not making her elbow open up first. That's a mistake a lot of people make. We want the hand to come straight out first, right? Bruce Lee would throw his jabs this way, right? Called a vertical punch. A lot of old school boxers still will talk about this, right? But what we do is when we hit the face, if it's skinny like that, it gets through the guard, and then we turn it at the end. Okay, so don't raise your elbow, come straight out and turn it at the end. Some people really like to exaggerate the turn, and what they will do is they will turn the pinky all the way up, palm out. I like to split the difference on that. I don't go thumb up like the vertical jab. I don't go right here, I go just a little bit further than that, right? So that's fine if it's here, if it's here. And again, some of the old school still do it this way, and that's fine too. The twisting is good. Always helps us with the comeback motion, and it's just a really good way to be technical about your punch. Okay, so all to the head, single, double, triple, single, double, triple. Good. Okay, so again, I had her do a set on this, I had her do a set in the middle, I had her do a set over here, and that's fine. And we'll be doing stuff like that in class. Okay? Now we want to add on the twos, okay? Everybody knows the old 1-2. Even kids have heard that saying, I'll hit them with the 1-2 before they ever come to martial arts, right? So we'll say two. Two for us is a combo, 1-2. But sometimes we'll just say, hey, give me a two, right? And that just means just throwing a straight right hand for Cora, right? But what we're going to do is we're going to start adding twos onto this. So if we're doing single jab, and we're going to follow with the two, so give me a two. Or single two, right? When I say that, I don't mean for her to just throw the right hand. What I mean is the combo. Single two. A single jab and then a two punch, the cross. The straight right hand for Cora, straight left if you're a southpaw. Okay? Now give me a double two. Two jabs. Good. I like how she broke that up. Did you guys notice? She did a one, then a 1-2. One, one, two. Right? Do a double, then a two, right? So like two different timings so they can see the difference. See, that's different timing. We like to teach it like this. One, one, two. Right? That's how we're stacking them together. Now, a triple two. So what I want Cora to do is a one, 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 two. Right? Single, single, one, two. Good. Again. Single, single, one, two. Nice. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to do a double jab combo. We're going to set up a kick off of the end of what we always refer to as our boxing drill number one, jab, cross, hook, cross. So we're going to do jab, cross, hook, cross, rear leg. So that's like that double two. So we say single two, double two, triple two when we're calling numbers in class, right? Let's review that again, right? So just give me a single two, right? Just right there, single two, a single jab and a two, double two, one, one, two, and a triple two. right? That's what we're looking at. So now, Cora, give me a single, then a jab, cross, hook, cross, close the door with the rear leg. Single, jab, cross, hook, cross, close the door with the rear leg. Again, single, jab, cross, hook, cross, boom, right there. When we're kicking, particularly when we have shin pads on, we want to target right above the knee. You see where that muscle starts to contour? There's a nerve there, and that's where we like to kick the leg. In MMA, it's really popular to kick below the knee at the calf. Right? We watched UFC fights last night. Conor McGregor, he was getting kicked there all the time, right, by Dustin Poirier. So it's something we see in sport, right? But we like to kick right above the knee. That doesn't mean we wouldn't kick to the body or the head either. So you got to kind of be open about that when you're sparring, right? So that's our jab sets for our yellow and orange belts, beginners, youth, and teen MMA.